It's time to tear down the Mi Mix, the new bezel-less smartphone from Xiaomi. As you can see, this phone has no earpiece. I'll explain how and even let you hear the audio quality of a phone call later in this video as well. Let's see what this thing is made of. Remember that this whole phone is made out of ceramic, a super hard and brittle material that scratches at an 8 on Mohs scale of hardness. Because of this, the back is actually pretty hard to remove. Even though there is no adhesive, it is held in place by a series of snaps. And since the frame and back don't flex, my thin pry tool struggles to get inside. I was eventually successful though, and the back panel pops right off. It's nice not having to use a heat gun for a change. The fingerprint scanner has an accordion-style ribbon cable attaching it to the motherboard, so be careful not to rip that. There are 10 regular Phillips head screws holding down the plastic shield over the mainboard. Keep your screws organized, and I'll be linking a toolkit and replacement parts in the video description of this video. Once that protective plastic is off the mainboard, we can unclip the fingerprint scanner, just like a little Lego. Then the rear flash and camera lens on the back panel are also replaceable at this point. It is important to disconnect the battery first. Then we have the screen ribbon on the left, and the front camera, and the power button ribbons, and the extension ribbon for the charging port, all unsnapping like little Legos. This clear plastic is actually the earpiece right here along the edge, and I'll get to that in just a second. To remove the 4300 milliamp hour battery, it has some of the magical pull tabs at the bottom that easily slide out the adhesive from underneath the battery. Unfortunately, these are also very easy to break, and if they do break, you must commence the pry of shame, taking immense care not to puncture or bend the battery during this pry, because the batteries do catch fire when punctured. Also, watch out for these extension ribbons under the battery if you're wanting your phone to still function after the battery removal. Here's the rear 16 megapixel camera for the Mi Mix, and judging by the fact that the lens does not move around inside of its housing like on the Galaxy or newer iPhones, I'm going to say that it does not have OIS, which is unfortunate. Xiaomi has used OIS on some of their other phones though. One more wire cable to remove, and then there is a little screw holding in the vibrating piezoelectric earpiece. I should have taken out the SIM card tray before I started this teardown, but sometimes I get a little too excited. The motherboard is held down by a little latch on the top left corner, so unclip that and the motherboard pops out. Now you can see where the processor sits, and some of this thermal rubber stuff to help the heat dissipation. Let's look at this piezoelectric speaker. This is the thing that makes noise by vibrating the actual frame of the phone. So during a phone call, no matter where your ear is along the frame, on either side, front or back of the phone, you can hear sound emanating from the device. It's rather weird. I knew the most asked comment in the comment section would be, "Hey Jerry, how does this vibrating earpiece sound?" So, don't worry. I'm gonna let you hear it for yourself.
So this is what the earpiece sounds like from the iPhone 7. This is the standard earpiece that has a little tiny speaker inside, and this is what most every Android and iPhone have inside of them.
And this is what the piezo or piezoelectric speaker sounds like inside of the Mi Mix. This speaker is making sounds by just vibrating a little bit and doesn't actually have a speaker inside of it like most other phones do. So now you can tell the sound difference between the two phones.
While both speakers are clear and understandable, to me, the Mi Mix sounds a little bit like the other person is on speakerphone, when they actually aren't. But it's still a pretty cool invention, and it's fun to see innovation in the cell phone world. The charging port shroud is held down by 5 more screws. I'll remove that. The shroud has the loudspeaker attached to it as well. Unclip 2 more ribbon cables and the signal wire, and we get to look at the bottom microphone and the USB-C charging port. It's nice that the charging port is replaceable. The 5 megapixel front-facing camera is also down here at the bottom of the phone, strangely enough, and it has the longest ribbon cable that I have ever seen attached to a camera. It wraps all the way up the side of the phone to the mainboard above the battery. Pretty crazy. One of the things I mentioned during my drop test video was that the ceramic frame of the phone would be damaged easily during drops. The good news is, the frame is absolutely replaceable. With 12 silver screws holding it in place, it can pop off from the frame of the screen. Replacement parts for this phone are going to be hard to find since this phone is limited production, but it's good to know that Xiaomi is planning for the future if they mass produce ceramic phones. The frame is replaceable. Very smart. They really need to include a rubber barrier between the frame and the screen though to minimize damage transfer to the front glass during drops. Speaking of the screen, this is it. It is adhered to the midframe, and hopefully Xiaomi will sell replacement screens already attached to the midframe. But if they don't, you'll have to remove the old display from the midframe and attach the midframe to the new screen. I'll link any replacement parts that I find in the video description, but like I said before, they are going to be difficult to find. I'll get those 12 screws around the ceramic frame in place, and then the charging port can go back in its slot. Down here at the bottom microphone holes, most of them are for decoration. The mic only fills one hole, so make sure that particular hole is never plugged up. Get that wire cable plugged in, along with the two ribbons next to it, and the front-facing camera. The plastic loudspeaker and its 5 screws go down on top of that. Then the piezoelectric speaker gets set down before the motherboard does. There is a little pin and a screw hole that guide it in place. The motherboard can be set down after that. Clipping in the wire cable, the extension ribbon down to the charging port, the screen ribbon and the power button ribbon, and the front camera ribbon. Then the rear camera can also get snapped in, and finally, the battery. Before putting the protective plastic layer in place, make sure that the fingerprint scanner is also clipped in, just like a little Lego. 10 screws later, and you can take the ceramic back and snap that into place. Make sure that the phone is working first, because getting the back panel off if you forgot something is a real chore. Overall, the Xiaomi Mi Mix has a solid build. The earpiece is very interesting, and I'm super glad that the ceramic frame can be replaced. I wish the camera had OIS, but at least the phone is good looking. My channel is full of teardown reviews like this one. Bonus points for following me on Instagram and Twitter. I post most of my behind the scenes stuff over there. Thanks a ton for watching. I'll see you around.